Nazi-Soviet Pact. We discussed about how important was the Nazi-Soviet Pact. One of the most astonishing and surprising events resulting from Hitler's foreign policy was the announcement in late August 1939 of the Nazi-Soviet Pact. This was called also Ribbentrop-Molotov Act because of the people who actually signed this pact, the foreign ministers of Germany and respectively Soviet Union. Publicly, this was actually a 10-year non-aggression pact, and privately, it contained clauses relating to future partition of Poland. So basically, Germany and Soviet Russia splitting Poland in two. At first sight, the agreement was really a very unlikely event because of the incompatibility between Hitler and Stalin. There were two states portraying different ideological views, opposed ideological views, fascism and communism, making a deal with one another, which was unheard of. Hitler had never made any secret of his hatred for communism. If you remember in Mein Kampf, My Struggle, the book he wrote in prison, while in prison, had argued in favor of the destruction of the Soviet Russia. So it was a no-brainer that this thing won't happen. But history has many mysteries. Stalin was well aware of German intentions and expected an invasion of his country at some point, so he was not stupid. He believed that this thing will come. Yet on another level, this pact made perfect sense because you unite in a war to defeat a common enemy or something like that. Remember what happened with the Soviet Union uniting with the other countries to defeat Hitler, and after that the Cold War, which was clearly an ideological war between West and East, between communism and capitalism. So Hitler wanted to ensure that, having defeated Poland, he was not attacked by Soviet Russia while he dealt with Britain and France. Stalin hoped that an Anglo-French-German war would last many years and wanted to buy time to strengthen his defenses and build up his military machinery, which was actually what happened. Stalin also feared a war on two fronts, given the current hostility of Japan towards the Soviet Union, and remember Anti-Comintern Pact and everything else. So it suited the short-term ambitions of both Germany and Soviet Russia to do a deal with one another. The immediate result, of course, was to seal the fate of Poland. Poland was lost. If Hitler invaded, as he now made immediate plans to do, there was absolutely nothing that Britain or France could do to assist their ally other than wage a general war against Germany, which was quite difficult. Hitler had no reason to suppose that French opposition would be any more serious than it had been over Czechoslovakia, for example, because that was the last thing we've done. Also, Hitler's diplomatic hand had strengthened since the Munich Agreement, as Italy had become a formal ally in the Pact of Steel of May 1939. So for all the parts involved, Nazi-Soviet Pact made sense for short term. For the entire world, it didn't make any sense because it was a kind of double approach from a fascist point of view and from a communist point of view.